Interstate remover furniture. Interstate, tune into this webinar today, good brother.
John.
Troy and Boone.
Good morning, sir.
Don't call me sir. I work for a living.
Come. I knew you was going
to
say that.
That's one of the greatest insults that you could actually introduce to the foul mouth Kahan, man, is sir. Sir is a surname that was given to the people that was considered to be chattel property. Remember, during biblical times, we didn't have any surname. We just had one name. You know what I mean? Nobody had a surname. The Romans started that so they could tax people. And that's why they do it today, man. They want to be able to tax people, man. So they give us surnames to try and link us, and they give us a number that they call a social insurance number or social security number. But John Bourne, I'm about to do, you probably out on Big Reels rolling, right? On the highway, right?
Yeah, actually, I'm headed to Florida.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So you won't be able to attend. I'm about to do a webinar today. Some information that you haven't been introduced to on consumer law. But,
oh, man. I love consumer law. Go ahead.
Yeah. So, real quick, because there's some people listening to you in the background. Have you had successful remedies with any of the methods that Kahan Tazadaq is actually introduced? Now, you said it before, but this is a new crowd. I see some new people in the audience. Can you tell them how much debt that you effectively discharge with the EFT method only?
Oh, man. I'm so glad and honored that you would even consider to call me and ask such a question, but absolutely. I have effectively discharged over $100,000 with just the EFT method only. EFT is going to be one of the methods that's going to be much easier to grasp onto. Actually, with some of these EFTs that I did, I actually wrote it up to where they would send me a difference check back.
Mm-hmm.
So after I did the EFT, so quick example, let's say the debt was $5,000, I might have sent in $5,100.
Mm-hmm.
And then they actually sent me a check back saying, hey, we agree to the terms that you have stipulated in your EFT. Here is the difference check. You have a good day. That's been on multiple occasions with the EFT. I mean, it is so effective. You can be in debt today, and when they receive it, boom, you are literally out of debt.
Jai Deer,
go ahead.
Just done 13,000.
He admitted yesterday. Very humble we though.
Golly.
Very humble we. Now, if you had to tell them to get one book, what's the one book would you tell them to get?
Oh, man, Liberate the Oppressed. You cannot go wrong with that book. And as I always state, just because we're currently speaking about EFT, there's a whole deluge of information that is in that book. I'm still trying to go through the book. And I think I got that book back in 2021, and I'm still trying to go through everything in it. Excuse me. You can't go wrong. If you're going to be serious about this, you have got to get Liberate the Oppressed. It's gonna knock it out of the park for you, because you are going to know how to correspond back and forth with the alleged creditors, you know, based on their responses, because, you know, some of these people are going to want to challenge you for whatever reason. They know that what you're doing is legitimate. It is correct. It is right. But they want to test and challenge you and see what you know. So as long as you follow through what Kahan is stating here in this webinar, and then, of course, what Liberate the Oppressed shows you, you can't go wrong. That's like the Bible. That's like the Bible of EFTs and other information, but for this webinar, I'll just speak about the EFT. But absolutely, let's see. Actually, the debt that I'm always talking about that I had discharged, I had sent them an EFT, and that EFT was close to $17,000. It was like $16,652, $689 and some change. And I sent that in to them. A few days went by, and they sent me a confirmation email. Thank you, John, for sending your correspondence through email. Give us a few days, and we will update your account, and your account will be labeled as paid in full.
Now, I got one thing, John. Someone sent me, last night, someone sent me a video of some dude had his face covered. Say, I don't listen to Kahan Tazadaq. His methods didn't work. I asked for my money back. What would you say for someone like that? From you?
First of all, if someone is actually displaying a video and their face is covered, that should already bring a red flag to the individual that's watching. I mean, Kahan Tazadaq, you can contact him through email. You can contact him through the webinars, a phone number. I mean, he puts a face with the actual name. So, I mean, as long as you call him and say, hey, this is what I'm dealing with, and it's adequate amount of time or whatever it is that you're dealing with, because, you know, Kahan, he teaches on multiple things, not just the EFT. But I would tell you that individual that's sending that information, that is actually disinformation. And everything that is taught here at TrueDisciplesOfChrist.org is the truth, and it's nothing but the truth. And you can't go wrong with that. I've watched it over the years, firsthand knowledge personally myself, and I continue to still see people get remedy, and they come back. Because once you find remedy, why would you go anywhere else? There's no reason to go anywhere else. This is, if you are on this call right now and you have stumbled upon TrueDisciplesOfChrist.org, this is the place that you need to be if you want to find remedy for your debts.
Now, real quick, can you share that story that you shared with us yesterday about when you first, before you started when you contact that briefcase?
Oh, yeah. Good point. I am so glad that you brought that up. Yeah. Okay. So for those of you that are skeptics, just like I was in the beginning, because, you know, I didn't know Kahan, just like you guys and ladies on this call. In the beginning, I stumbled upon the webinar and so forth, and I decided that I was going to do a little bit of studying before I even contacted the Kahan preliminary. So what I actually did, of course, HJR 192, Chapter 48 Stat 112, Public Policy 73-10. So what I decided to do, I actually contacted a law firm, and I wanted to ask them, because I was still in that mindset, you know, much like a lot of people on this call, which is fine because, you know, we were taught a certain way. And so I said, hey, I'm going to call this law firm and I'm going to ask somebody about this law to see if it is still in effect. So, you know, I called and they picked up and they said, hey, you know, what can we do for you today? And I said, well, my name is John. I have a question for you. I'd like somebody to do some research and get back to me on this, because I think that this is something I would like to know about. They said, okay, so what is your question? So I said, well, I'm actually calling in about HJR 192, Chapter 48 Stat 112, Public Policy 73-10. He said, okay, well, hold on. Let me write all of that down. And he got, you know, all of the information and so forth. And he said, if you don't mind, Mr. Bowen, And of course, I rebutted that, like we did earlier in this call, the term Mr. And he said, let me write down all this information and I will call you back and I will give you an answer. And I said, okay, with that being said, respectfully, because, you know, at that time, I was literally calling as a client because I was in that mindset. And I said, well, respectfully, when you contact me, I'm really not interested in what your opinion is, respectfully. And he said, okay, I completely understand. When I call you back, I'll just give you the facts. Now, keep in mind, he said, I'm going to give you the facts, but he didn't really know exactly what he was going to be looking up. And there's a possible conflict of interest for him to tell me the information that he was going to call back and tell me. So a few days passed by. Ring, ring, ring. Yeah, hello. Is this John? I said, well, yes, this is John. What can I help you with? This is such and such law firm. I'm actually returning your phone call and getting back to you on the information that you had requested. I said, okay, great. What do you have for me? He said, well, John, I wanted to stipulate that the information that you are requesting, it is on the books. The law is still there and it is legitimate and it has not been, I guess you could say, redacted. But immediately after he said that, now keep in mind, I had told him respectfully that I didn't care anything about receiving his opinion. I just wanted the law. He said, with that said, Mr. Bowen, I would urge you not to use this law. And I said to myself, so if the law is the law, why would you not urge me to use what is still on the books? And he said, well, I just don't think you should be using this. And I said, well, you know, respectfully, once again, I stated before and after and during that I really wasn't interested in hearing your opinion. But I do appreciate you calling me back and justifying that the law that I had requested you to look up is still on the books. And he said, yes, Mr. Bowen, it is. Is there anything else I can help you with? I said, nope, I think that's going to be it. I greatly appreciate your help. And so when I heard that for the first time from a law firm, I said, oh man, the Han Tazadaq, this guy, he is telling the truth. So secondly, I went ahead after I got that information. I was looking at one of his other videos and he said, if you are still in denial about anything that I am saying, he said, there's a document that you can get from the Library of Congress. I said, oh, really? So I decided to go and look up that document. And once again, it is HJR 192, Chapter 48, 48 Stat 112, Public Policy 73-10. So I went to the Library of Congress. You can actually go online and pull this document up. It will cost you, or at least at that time, back in 2021, it will cost you $96.50. So what that document is, it states that there is no legal tender out there except gold and silver. But if you are a secured party creditor and you know how to utilize the EFT, you can use that type of money, which is going to be issued through the U.S. Treasury. So that is what actually I did. I received it through the mail. My wife called me and she said, you got something from the Library of Congress. I said, oh, yeah, go ahead, open that up. Take a picture of it. She opened it up. It had a big, nice stamp on it, a bow on the front of it. And it went over exactly what I'm telling you guys right now over the phone. So even though you don't know me, you may not know Kahan Tazadaq, but you can go and get that document yourself and it'll pull it up and they'll send it to you stamped. And by doing that, that will actually build your own personal confidence in the process. You'll have something to hang your hat on, And most of all, you'll cast out doubt. So even when you see all these other YouTubers and people that are telling you, hey, you shouldn't do this, it'll actually get rid of all of that, because now you have a focus on the truth. And so, you know, I hope nobody's, you know, going through foreclosure or anything like that. But I don't know if anybody noticed that, you know, the economy, they're turning it up on everybody out there. And, you know, you got to have something to hedge you and your family against, you know, this inflation, skyrocketing prices. This is the place to get it at. That's all I got to say for now.
Appreciate it. Troy, what you got?